frontier. These are the voyages of the trash vessel Enterprise. Their mission? To explore strange new landfills, to seek out new junk and new incinerations, to boldly smell what no one has smelled before. Tonight's episode, The Laundry Chute.
Captain's log, stardate 90210. I was leaping through the latest Victoria's Secrets catalog when I received coded instructions from Admiral Tungsten ordering us to the Winkle system to pick up 80 tons of soiled diapers. The ship is set on course and we shall be arriving at approximately 1300 hours.
Captain's log out. Enter. Turkey, how nice to see you.
Sorry to disturb you, sir.
Nonsense, I've been disturbed. It's one of them left dressing cads up in ladies' costumes. Now, what is it that you wanted to see me about?
Well, sir, are those important schematics you requested?
Ah, very good. Yes, yes, what? Ah, yes, yes. I see you've left out the Ferris wheel.
Well, sir, your room is only so large.
Oh, well, better that than the 9-foot pickle.
Pikery to retard.
Go ahead, number two.
One.
Proceed, bump, number one.
We are picking up a space-time anomaly.
What? Again? I thought that was last season.
Your presence is requested on the bridge, sir.
On my way.
The anomaly appears to be 700 kilometers off our starboard bow.
Sensors are picking up an exponential increase in more impulses affecting the space-time continuum.
Suggestions. You have an idea, Mr. Bob?
Oh, no, sir. I was just clearing my throat.
Ah, very well.
Perhaps if we realigned the coaxial spheric registers and reprogrammed a Crouton torpedo to emit a regular burst of antimatter, the temporal damage could be reversed.
Hear that, we could just turn around and go the other way.
Excellent! Make it so.
Yes, Captain.
Well, that was certainly a close call. Come on, number seven.
No, thank you, Captain. I was wondering if you had a moment, though.
Certainly, number 26. Go ahead.
Well, I've been having some problems with the duty roster.
Damn, another pink one.
Well, I've got Palkovich and Benson on maintenance detail, Irvings and McDaniel on sweeping out shuttleway number 12, and Ethelheimer and Kranz are in charge of backing over garbage cans.
So what's the problem?
Well, to be truthful, sir, I've been having some problems with a certain member of the senior staff.
The crew talent show. Show tunes are not honorable.
Stop and nonsense, Mr. Bob. Why, I myself am doing an impersonation of Queen Mary of Scots riding a unicycle, singing Old Man River. And Mr. Ditto, training his little dog Patches to balance a phaser on its nose.
Ah!
Come, be a sport, Mr. Bob.
It would mean so much to the crew.
Oh, all right. I was working on this little puppet show about an adorable little rabbit and his fuzzy little friends.
That's the Bob I know.
Captain, my acute olfactory senses are picking up a multiplied increase in negative aromas.
Yeah, man, this place is really starting to reek.
Number 15, who's responsible for securing the garbage on board the bridge?
Viola, sir.
What? Since when?
Since the mission started 6 years ago.
Really? Mr. Bob, take this garbage immediately to the incinerator at once.
This is disgraceful. I am a member of a proud warrior race.
And you don't get paid $6.25 an hour to stand around and kick your butt.
Aye, sir.
Captain, I'm detecting a shift in the phlegmatic force.
It appears that someone or something is attempting to beam aboard our ship.
Shields up.
Shields do not respond, sir. Blue alert!
Attention all Kmart shoppers. All health and beauty aids in aisle 7 are now on sale for 50% off.
Red alert, sir! Red!
Right! Red alert!
Here, quick, flyless!
Beam in progress. 67% success and increasing.
Mayday! Mayday! Ranger shields! Move to the children first! Mayday! Mayday!
Get a hold of yourself, sir! Get a hold of yourself! My God, it may be a benevolent beam!
What's with that? Back here, quiet.
Than I imagined.
Wesley, rush her.
Cancel red alert.
Why?
Hiya, Captain. So what mistakes have you made lately?
I'll let you board my ship.
Say, how did you get on here? How is that possible?
As a project at the Academy, I reconfigured a way to redevelop theories and practicalities of time-space matter transport, enabling me to project my atoms virtually anywhere in the universe.
Most remarkable.
I thought so. So, where is my mom?
Your mother is with Counselor Floyd on W9, attending a couple of parties.
Gosh, that's too bad. Guess I just have to make myself home until she gets back.
I think not. I mean, it would be so silly of you to waste your time here on the bridge. You could be doing something much more useful at Starfleet Academy, like hanging yourself with piano wire.
Of course not. I received a 4-week pass from the Academy due to my academic excellence and my expertise in flight management.
Indeed.
Yes, this means I'll be back on board the Enterprise, so catch up on old times and start over again where we left off. Jerky, is it me or have you changed a little since last time I was here?
But Captain, is it just me or has Lieutenant Commander Jerky LaFork undergone some severe deterioration in skin pigment?
Definition.
Well, in layman's terms, the skin is the color of my left butt cheek.
What? You mean I'm not black? It feels like I'm black. Game over, man! You lied to me! Get you all out of here, man!
I hate that!
Ensign Smith, good to see you back again.
Actually, it's Ensign Stevens, sir, and back from where?
Number 15, I could have sworn that this man was eaten by a billion death spider 3 episodes ago.
Well, he was, sir, but remember, he is the all-purpose disposable crew member who comes with each and every episode.
Ah, yes. Carry on, Ensign, carry on.
Well, I came to report that there's currently a food fight underway in 28 forward.
What? Damn you, Ensign! I was too lucky to throw the first artichoke!
You are, sir.
Number 5, and Bob. You're with me.
Thank you.
closely. You'll find your stay in the little prize much more enjoyable if you are not forced to eat your arms.
That full of jello at me.
Captain, I must respectfully correct you. That bowl of jello hit me.
Really, Bob? Well, nice interception anyway. And good luck with those cats, number 52. Wesley?
When Counselor Ploy is not on the ship, we remove the chair from the bridge.
Oh, really? Where to?
The sun.
Captain, we are receiving a message from Starfluke.
On screen.
Ah, Admiral Gumby, what a pleasant surprise. What will we do for you?
Captain Riton, I have a mission for you and your crew. You are to take the litter prize to the coordinates which I am faxing to you now.
But sir, what about the wrinkle system and the 80 tons of soiled diapers?
No need to worry about that, Captain. We have the matter well in hand. Now then, here's your new mission. 3 days ago, we lost contact with a very important compost colony in the leavage system. Of course, we sent a scout ship to investigate. As you can probably guess, it did not return. You are to take the litter prize and find out what happened to the scout ship and the colony.
Of course, sir. And might I ask the name of the scout ship's captain?
Funny you should ask that, Captain. I believe you know the captain of the vessel. Captain Gallant Braveheart.
Captain Braveheart? Why, isn't he the one who single-handedly defeated not one, but 3 alien invasions from Confederated space?
You mean the same man who saved 3 million people from the rampaging flood of Neptune by using his body as a human cork?
You mean the guy who guest starred on the show last week?
Shh. Yeah, that's him, Rita. Now, good luck. All right? Okay?
Right. Dino, ahead. Warp factor 28.
Three.
Engage.
Captain's log supplemental. We've beamed down 2 expendable crew members to the planet's surface to take compost samples for our labs to analyze.
Compost.
You said, Artie, I sure do eat human compost.
That's what I said.
That's what you said, Artie. Can you eat human compost?
Shut up, Lloyd.
Okay, Artie. Hey, Artie, tell me something.
Yeah, what is it?
Have we taken any hallucinogenic drugs in the last 24 hours?
No, not today.
Engage. Nothing like a little nap to refresh the body, spirit, and mind.
Respectfully speaking, sir, you've been asleep for 3 days.
What? Where's Wesley?
Oh, the crew and I thought it would be best if Wesley was beamed directly into the center of a spatial anomaly and we await your command.
Excellent. Make it so.
Aye, sir.
Captain, sensors indicate that Ensign Harley employs life signs have disappeared from the surface of the planet. Captain, may I suggest
suggest that we send out an away party to investigate.
Excellent idea, number 3543, the hat. Why don't you take Mr. Ditto and Mr. Bob with you?
With me, sir? Oh, well, as much as I'd like to lead the away party myself personally, darned if I don't have to bake brownies for the women's auxiliary.
That's too bad, Swill. Well, I suppose there's nothing more for me to do than lead the away party myself.
Sir, are you sure that's a good idea?
What do you mean?
Well, with your extensive knowledge of Starfleet tactics and ship security, I... Never mind, Captain. We really should look into getting the transporter chief replaced.
Now, Mr. Bob. The crime is improving.
Indeed. Only last week you were still beaming people in the solid bedrock. Readings indicate life forms approximately 500 meters north of our current position.
Right. Follow me.
Captain, north is that way.
Just making a perimeter check.
Appears to be constructed of
cheap metal.
And what else do your sensors indicate, Mr. Ditto?
The structure consists of three separate levels. Power levels are minimal, but I detect two life forms within.
And what else do your sensors indicate, Mr. Ditto?
I detect a foul stench emanating from Lieutenant Barf's boots.
We have been walking for some time.
Suggestions on how to get in?
Open the door.
Do you really believe that someone would be so stupid as to leave their door unlocked? Turn on the lights, Mr. Barth. Turn off the lights, Mr. Barth.
You're all comfortable, I trust.
Braveheart, what is the meaning of this?
Of this? Pronoun indicating the personal thing just indicated or mentioned. This man is my friend. This is my dog. This galaxy will soon be mine.
So, you're responsible for the disappearance of the colonists?
Yes.
And one may also infer that you are also behind the disappearance of Ensigns Harley and Floyd.
Oh, indeed.
And I just bet you had a hand in the cancellation of Perfect Strangers.
Yeah. No.
Oh?
But I will be responsible for your cancellations.
My God, man, what's gotten into you?
In all my years battling evil and injustice in the galaxy, I have come to the inevitable conclusion that villains make far more interesting characters.
A valid point, Captain. In most forms of Earth literature, it is the villain, the antagonist, who heightens the urgency of the climax. In fact, most memorable villains have endured themselves far on beyond the normal.
Shut up.
Yes, sir.
Well, as much as I'd love to stay here and chat with you, I have places to go, planets to level, civilizations to conquer, but you do understand, of course.
Wait a minute, Braveheart! You can't leave here first without revealing your entire dastardly plan for intergalactic mayhem to us.
Ah, but of course, I almost completely forgot. Ah, you must forgive me. I'm still rather new to this villain business. Hmm. But this is the point in the story where I, as the villain, am required to reveal my entire brilliant scheme to you, only to have you escape from my seemingly inescapable death trap at the very last possible moment.
Enough of this. You are without honor, Captain Braveheart. Now, Mr. Bart. It's our job as heroes to hear him out. Proceed, Captain.
Thank you, Captain. Now then, using your ship, I shall proceed to the nearest star base, where I shall be greeted with open arms and a hero's welcome. Once the shields are lowered to let my ship dock, I shall open fire on the station with Crouton torpedoes, damaging their life support systems irrevocably. I will then send a subspace message to all nearby Starfleet personnel, demanding a ransom for the station's dwindling life, a ransom of such ridiculously tremendous proportion that I shall bankrupt the entire economy. I shall then swoop in and purchase a controlling interest in all major publicly held corporations, partnerships, and other limited business ventures. Now then, assuming an annual percentage rate of 10.3%, the net present value of said economy should be, after a period of 5 years...
Wait a minute, Braveheart! You've left off one important fact.
And what, pray tell, is that?
Assuming you can't beam on board our ship, how do you plan on taking on my intrepid bridge crew?
A lone, unarmed jungle leader would be able to take command of your vessel with no difficulty whatsoever, and would give orders much more effectively, I might add.
An accurate assessment, Captain.
But nonetheless, I will have assistance. Allow me to introduce one of the indigenous beings of this planet. Beings which have suffered long at the hands of the Confederation.
My God!
Oh, forgive me, Alex. Here is your translator.
Alentes loco, queremos tanto, captela de noche a...
Sorry, wrong chat.
I am a Turnian. We have been observing your puny human efforts to subjugate us by harvesting our young.
What do you mean? We were simply mining compost to use in Confederated kumquat gardens.
Turnians in their normal stage.
Well, if you want to split hairs.
Enough! Many of our race burrowed deeper into the bowels of Turdia, hoping to avoid further contact with your race. But some of us wanted vengeance, and so we remained behind and took over the colony and enslaved the colonists. That is when the human Braveheart came to us, investigating their disappearance. He had the foresight to betray his crew and aid us in this, the most noble of causes.
Well, that stinks.
Exactly, retard human. Soon, the entire galaxy will reek of Turnians!
A foul plan indeed. And now, gentlemen, without further ado, my destiny awaits. As does yours.
Captain's log supplemental. The litter prize remains in orbit around the planet of Turdia. Still, no word from the away party. And, to make matters worse, Lieutenant Commander Jerky LaForte insists on reading Horton Hears a Who into the captain's log.
In the 15th of May, in the jungle of Newell, in the heat of the day, in the...
Gay, that fool!
He was splashing! Enjoy the...
You live by the wind and enjoy!
We beamed down the planet.
Yep, we beamed down.
There were
elephants. Yes, yes, he saw them and...
Watching Jeopardy
and...
They had yogurt! Yes! He loved yogurt! Yeah,
so he went down to buy and get some yogurt from a pink elephant.
Yes!
My superhuman strength to break free of my bonds and overpower the fecal fiend.
Well, why didn't you say so to begin with?
I was merely waiting for the most dramatically appropriate moment, sir.
Oh, terrific. After I've already created several miniature tertians in my drawers.
Make it so, Mr. Dillon, quickly. You know what to do?
Right. Idea after all.
I detect a transporter pad approximately 1.4 kilometers west of here.
How about a sink?
Right this way, sir.
What we need is a plan.
I have just the one, sir.
A squirt gun to defeat me, retard.
Ah, but that's what you think. This is no ordinary squirt gun. This is, in fact, an enema!
Ha 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 ha!
Yeah, sign another one.
No, Bob!